Hello children, welcome to my channel. In this video I will teach arithmetic progression part 4. Okay, 3 parts are over. This is the 4th part and the last part. Okay, in this part we will move to 3 or more terms open AP. Okay, if 3 unknown terms are given, open AP, or 4 unknown terms means order even, okay, 5 terms, 6 terms, like this also given, then you can find the terms. First let us move to odd. Okay, suppose 3 fingers, okay, odd. Okay, one finger is in the middle. Okay, if there are 3 fingers, then one finger is in the middle. 5 fingers, okay, again odd, then one finger is in the middle. Okay, if I take 7 fingers, okay, odd, then again this finger, okay, this finger is in the middle. Left side 3 fingers, right side also 3 fingers. Okay, you can see when we are taking odd number of terms, one term is in the middle. Okay, give importance to that one term, middle term. Let the middle term be A, then we have to choose the next and previous term. Let the next term be A plus D, the previous term should be A minus D. The middle term is very important. Okay, the next term will be A plus 2D, the previous term will be A minus 2D. Similarly, it will continue. A plus 3D, okay, this will be A minus 3D. So remember, when you are given odd number of terms, 3, 5, 7, 9, etc., then you have to take in this way. If 3 terms, then take, let the terms be A minus D, A and A plus D. If 5 terms, then A minus 2D, A minus D, A plus D, A plus 2D. So choose the middle term first. Now let us move to even number of terms. If we have even number of terms, there are 4 fingers, which finger is in the middle? Okay, there is no such finger which is in the middle, or you can say these 2 fingers are in the middle. So when there are even terms, 2 terms are in the middle, these 2 terms, these 2 fingers. Similarly, suppose I have taken 6 fingers, which fingers are in the middle? These 2 fingers, okay, the left index finger and the left middle finger. So these 2 fingers are in the middle. Okay, so when we are taking even number of terms, 2 terms are in the middle. Choose the 2 terms first. Let the 2 terms be A minus D and A plus D. These 2 are important. Okay, the next term should be A plus 3D. Now you may be wondering, why it is not A plus 2D? Here it was A plus D, then A plus 2D, 1 increasing, D increasing. But here from D I jumped to 3D, I did not take 2D. Why I did not take 2D? There is a reason for it. See these 2 terms, what is the common difference? Right minus left, okay? The common difference, suppose I am giving capital D, okay? To avoid confusion, I am giving capital D is equal to right minus left, means A plus D minus A minus D, okay, which is equal to A plus D minus A plus D. Okay, so A cancel 2D. So common difference is not D. Here the common difference was D. So I took plus D plus D plus D. But here the common difference is not D, it is 2D. So I could take plus 2D. Okay, for that reason, from after D I have taken 3D. Okay, that is the reason, because here the common difference is not D, it is 2D. So choose the previous term, it should be A minus 3D. The next term will be A plus 5D, in this way it will continue. The previous term will be A minus 5D, in this way it will continue. So remember, When odd number of terms are given, choose the middle term A, then plus D minus D, plus D minus D. If the number of terms is even, then choose two terms in the middle, A minus D, A plus D. Then the right left will be A plus 3D, A minus 3D, A plus 5D, A minus 5D, 2 to jump. Okay? So using this concept, let us solve some examples. Find three numbers in AP. Okay, one example. Find three numbers in AP whose sum is 24. Okay, sum is 24 given. Product is 440. Product is equal to 440. Okay, we have to find three terms which are in AP or three numbers which are in AP. Whose sum is 24 and product is 440. 3 means odd. Okay, so let the terms be A minus D, A and A plus D. I have told if odd number of terms, then choose the middle one first. So these are the three terms, suppose. Now according to the question, sum is 24, that means A minus D plus A plus A plus D should be 24. Sum of the three numbers. Okay, so D, D cancel, A plus A is 3A, this is 24, A is equal to 8. We got A, our next target is D, anyhow we need D, that we got get from the product. Okay, so A minus D into A plus D is 440. What is A minus D? 8 minus D. D is unknown to us now. What is A? 8. What is A plus D? 8 plus D is 440. Now see, 8 minus D into 8 plus D. It is in the form of A minus B into A plus B, which is equal to A square minus B square. Okay? So A square minus B square means 8 square minus D square. Then this 8 I will take to the right. So 440 by 8. 440 by 8 is equal to 555. Okay? So x square minus b square is equal to 55. X square is 64. 64 minus b square is 55. Take this to the right. Bring 55 to the left. So 64 minus 55 is 9. And minus b square becomes plus b square. So b square is equal to 9. B is equal to square root of 9. Square root means plus minus, which is equal to plus or minus 3. We got A. A is how much? 8. D is equal to either plus 3 or minus 3. D can be positive, D can be negative. Now let us find the terms. Okay. Remember A is 8. There are two values for D, plus 3 and minus 3. So one by one we have to choose for D is equal to 3 or plus 3. Okay. The first term is A minus D. Okay. Which is equal to, what is A? 8. We have got A is equal to 8. Okay. So 8 minus, what is D? 3. So 8 minus 3 is equal to 5. A2 is equal to A, second term is A, A is 8, A is 8, okay. A3 is equal to A plus D, A plus D, A plus D means 8, 8 plus 3, 8 plus 3 is 11. So these are the three numbers, 5, 8 and 11. If you add them, you will get 24. If you multiply them, you will get 440. This is for D is equal to plus 3. Then for D is equal to minus 3, the first term will be A minus D. Now you don't need to write, okay. Simply remember the trick. Once you find the three terms 5, 8, 11, just you have to reverse, okay. the first term will be 11. Definitely it will be 11. You can check a minus d. A minus d means 8 minus 3 means 8 plus 3, which is 11. So just have to reverse. A3 becomes A1, A2 is A2, A1 becomes A3. A2 is A, which is 8, it doesn't change, okay? And A3 is, the A1 becomes A3. Fine. So the three numbers are 5, 8, 11 or 11, 8, 5. If you add them, you get 24. If you multiply them, you get 440. Okay? So in this way, you will solve if three unknown terms are given, odd number of terms. Now let us move to even number of terms. Find 4 numbers in AP whose sum is 20. 4 numbers, okay? Means even. Sum is 20 and sum of whose squares, sum of whose squares is 120. Okay, if even, then I have told that you have to choose middle to first. Okay, so let the terms be a minus d, a plus d, first to middle. Okay, a plus 3d, a minus 3d. So let the four terms be, or the four numbers be a minus 3d, a minus d, a plus 3d. Okay, sum is given 20, so let us add them. A minus 3d plus a minus d plus a plus d plus a plus 3d is 20. Since I am adding plus, so you don't need to worry. Okay, when you see minus sign, then you have to be careful, you have to put bracket. Now see, 3d cancel, minus d plus d cancel. So a plus a plus a plus a is 4a, which is 20. So definitely our a is 20 by 4, that is 5. So successfully we have got a. Our next target is d. Okay. Sum of squares means a minus 3d whole square plus a minus d whole square plus a plus d whole square plus a plus 3d whole square is equal to 120. It was given, okay, 120 it was given. Okay, next, in expansion, in expansion class 9 we have studied that a plus b whole square plus a minus b whole square is equal to 2 whole a square plus b square. Okay, a plus b whole square plus a minus b whole square is equal to 2 whole a square plus b square. In class 9 expansion chapter we have studied this. We can use this here. Okay, these two are in the same format, a minus b whole square plus a plus b whole square. These two are also in the same format, a minus b whole square plus a plus b whole square. So we can use here the same formula. So a minus b whole square plus a plus b whole square equal to 2 whole a square plus b square. So 2 whole a square plus b square. So this part is over. Okay, then these two, again it is in the same format, 2 whole a square plus b square is equal to 120. Okay, a is equal to 5. Okay, a is equal to 5. I am writing here. You may forget that we have got. So this implies after this, okay, after this, whole a square plus 3d whole square is 9d square 2 whole a square plus d square is equal to 120. If you want, we can open the bracket or we can take 2 common. Let us open the bracket. 2 a square plus 18 d square plus 2 a square plus 2 d square is 120. So 2 a square plus 2 a square is 4 a square. 18 d square plus 2 d square, 20 d square is 120. Both sides can be divided by 4. Okay, 4, 20, 120 all are divisible by 4. So I am dividing by 4 to simplify. So a square plus 5 d square is equal to 30. Now put the below a, which you have already got. A square means 5 square, which is 25, plus 5 d square is 30. So 5 d square is 30 minus 25. 30 minus 25, okay, which is 5. So d square is 5 by 5, which is 1. D is equal to plus or minus 1. Okay, d is equal to plus or minus 1. We have got d now. We have got a, then we got d. Now we will find the terms. For b is equal to 1, first we will take 1, then we will take minus 1. First term was a minus 3d. Okay, first term was a minus 3d, I have taken. Okay, so a minus 3d means 5 minus 3 into 1, which is 3. So 2, first term is 2, second term is a minus d. A minus d means 5 minus 1, 4. Third term is a plus d, 5 plus 1, 6. Fourth term is a plus 3d, 5 plus 3. A is 5, 3d means 3 into 1, which is 3, 8. So these are the four numbers, 2, 4, 6 and 8. Okay, then for d is equal to minus 1, because there are two values of d, one is plus 1, one is minus 1. For 1 we got, then for minus 1 we will get a 1. You don't need to put a minus 3d, you don't need to calculate, just reverse. Okay, a is 6, 4, 2. A 1 is 8, a 2 is 6, a 3 is 4, a 4 is 2. Okay, so in this way, if you are given even number of terms, unknown terms of an AP, then you can use the concept and you can find it. Okay, now the last part of this video. Arithmetic mean. Okay, last part is arithmetic mean. Okay, if three terms A, B, C, suppose there are three terms A, B, C are in AP. Okay, if A, B, C are in AP, then B is called the arithmetic mean between A and C. Okay, how? Let us see. Because B minus A is equal to C minus B. If terms are in AP, then the difference should be constant. So B minus A should be equal to C minus B, because common difference is constant. So B minus A equal to C minus B, which is the common difference. So B plus B is C plus A, B to the left, A to the right. 2B is equal to A plus C, B is equal to A plus C by 2. So this is the formula to find the arithmetic mean between any two numbers. For example, find the arithmetic mean between 2 and 8. Suppose you have been asked to find the arithmetic mean between minus 2 and 8. Assume that minus 2 is A, 8 is C. You have been asked to find B. A and C are given. Okay, A and C are given. You have been asked to find B. So arithmetic mean is equal to A plus C by 2. So minus 2 plus 8 by 2. What is minus 2 plus 8? 6. Okay, 6 by 2. Which is 3. So the arithmetic mean between minus 2 and 8 is plus 3. I'll give one more example, then this will be the end of this part. Suppose find the arithmetic mean between 2 root 2 and 8 root 2. Okay, find the arithmetic mean between 2 root 2 and 8 root 2. Same concept. AM or arithmetic mean is equal to A plus C by 2 and 2 root 2 plus 8 root 2 by 2. 2 root 2 plus 8 root 2 is 10 root 2 by 2, which gives you 5 root 2. So the arithmetic mean is 5 root 2. I hope you have understood this video. Okay, so this is the end of arithmetic progression part 4, the last part. Thank you for watching.